get to run the bass low.
Hello and welcome everyone, Chiro here, and I thought it was time I did a guide on Go Wipe. Now, I did sort of one before, kind of halfway, but I think it's time to do a full one and redo everything on it. Now, for this one, I'm only going to be covering Go Wipes that use lightning. For the ones that don't use the lightning spell, I'm going to be doing another video in the next few days. It's just too many replays to put into one video. Instead, in this video, I'm going to be covering with the lightning spell, and then I'm going to be covering two golems and three golems with jump, without jump. So that's what's going to be covered in this video. There's going to be another video where I don't use the lightning spell, and that's going to be coming later. Then there's going to be GoWiiWi guides and GoWiiWipe guides and stuff like that. But that's going to be coming over the next week or two, so just stay tuned for that. And now let's get started with this. So I'm going to start first with my go-to army. It's the 2 Golem, 5 P.E.K.K.A, Lightning Spell, Jumping Go Wipe. That is what I use for the vast majority of my attacks when I use a Go Wipe. It's basically what I use all the time. Only rarely do I use something else. Now I'm going from this side because it seems like a logical side to go to, because I can see that long compartment will bring me right near the Town Hall. So all I have to do is get through that opening right there, or make an opening down below. But in that, I made a mistake. What I thought was a good thing for me to attack on this base, a good side, was actually a bad side, and you're gonna see why. I am getting my wall breakers close, but thankfully I have a jump spell. I don't need to worry about the multi-target Inferno Tower. I don't need to freeze it. I have my jump spell, and that's what I'm gonna use to get to the Town Hall. Now, if you can save it and get out of the core with the jump spell, that's what you wanna do. And here's how that long compartment screwed me up. Right here, all of my P.E.K.K.A and my king went down. My queen and one wizard are the only one going towards the town hall. The guys, all the P.E.K.K.A and the king, they went down there because of that long compartment that I saw was going to bring me towards the town hall. I probably should have attacked from the bottom. That would have been my best attack side for this base. But I was still able to get the 2-star, and my troops are still going. I still have a big group of P.E.K.K.A. It's great to have P.E.K.K.A all together. You want them together. You don't want, like, all five together. Because if you have all five together, what's going to happen is they're all going to swing at once. But they're going to hit it so hard that it will instantly kill and then over-damage any building. You kind of want a group of maybe 2 P.E.K.K.A at a time. Maybe 2, 2, and 1. Or 2 and 3. So stagger them a little bit. I'm a little bit heavy-handed when it comes to P.E.K.K.A sometimes. I might hold my finger down a little too long. Try and stagger your P.E.K.K.A just by a few seconds, just so they split up a little bit. You want them all going towards the core, but you don't want them to all be on top of each other, unless you're trying to break through walls, then that'll help. But if you're not trying to break through walls, you're just going to get over damage, which is wasted time, which is wasted damage, and just wasted troops. For this guy, I'm using the 3 Golem, but still with the jump. 3 Golem and a jump is what I'm using for this. I have less P.E.K.K.A. I have 4 P.E.K.K.A instead of 5 because I have that Golem, and I also have a little bit less Wizards. But I'm going through the top because I can see that it is a straight shot right through there to go down. If I get just straight down there, now my jump spell will get me to the Town Hall. Base designs like this are relatively common. The ones that have tops like this that are sort of shaped like an upside down V, you can just break straight down the top. That is a very common base design. And remember that by dropping my jump spell there and leading it towards my troops, I am still able to jump into the town hall. It doesn't have to necessarily be on the far walls. It has to be past the closer walls to your troops, but it doesn't even have to touch the far wall you want to jump. It could be one square away. Your troops will still jump. That's probably not intended by Supercell, but that's how it works. You can jump over walls that a jump technically isn't on, and that worked for me. I was able to get into the core, though they did break the side when they came back. And now I have troops going off to the side, kings going off to the side, but thankfully with the Rage Spell and the P.E.K.K.A, they're going to be able to break through that level 11 wall, and it actually hit the Archer Queen. That's where you want to place your Rage. You want to think, how can I get the most troops in it? And sometimes it may not look like you can get them all in. Most people probably would have just dropped it on the king and the P.E.K.K.A, but by angling it there, I was able to also get the queen in there and help her out. Even though she didn't really need it, she wasn't hitting anything particularly high in health, so it's not that big of a deal to get her in it. But do it when you can, at least practice it, because sometimes your troops will look a little bit far apart, but you can get them both in the Rage Spell. I would go as far as to say that the Rage Spell is the most important spell for a Go Wipe. It is not the Freeze Spell. The Freeze Spell is fairly important, but multi-target Inferno Towers won't hurt P.E.K.K.A. And single-target Inferno Towers will probably lock onto the Golems before they lock onto the P.E.K.K.A. And hopefully, with a Rage Spell, and maybe even a Jump Spell, your P.E.K.K.A. will already be there to destroy it. Now, up next, we're going to be having two Golems and no Jump Spell. So what you need to do for this is you need to bring more Wall Breakers, which is going to cut down on either your P.E.K.K.A. or your Wizards, whichever one, or maybe both, because you're going to need to bring a lot of Wall Breakers. You know, 18 plus Wall Breakers, especially if you're in Champions League. I know that sounds like a lot to some people, but I've seen people carrying as much as 24, 26 Wall Breakers, because the most important thing to Go Wipe overall, not like the most important spell, which is what I was talking about before, most important thing overall is getting through the base. That's why I always carry a Jump Spell normally. Normally, with my normal army, I carry a Jump Spell. Obviously, with this one, I'm not. I really like this base design right here for attacking because it can break all the way down, right? All the way down to the Town Hall, just in a straight line, and all my troops will go straight down there. Now, that was an alright free spell, but not great. I did get the Clan Castle along with that Expo right there, but I was also trying to get the Inferno Tower, and it did not work. On the other side, I was able to get the Inferno Tower, but the Queen was missed and was able to walk over the freeze. I really think that if they should walk on the freeze, they should get frozen. But whatever, it worked out. And now I'm just raging as much as I can. I'm gonna drop one more Rage Spell right here to help all those P.E.K.K.A. and the King. It looks like not that much, but there's a lot of troops right there. It's my King and most of my P.E.K.K.A. They're gonna get really stuck on a wall, but the Rage does help them get out just enough to destroy two buildings, but my King's gonna go down. The Tesla took out the P.E.K.K.A. That's your main worry with the Go Wipe, is those Tesla. The Tesla do double damage, and max level Tesla already do 99 DPS, so they're doing 198 damage every second per Tesla when you get near a max level Tesla with any P.E.K.K.A. Now I just have to clean up the last 50%. You can see I'm carrying extra troops. I don't drop all of my Wizards in most of my attacks, and I carry that little extra archery if I've got the space. What it is I keep those to pick off outside buildings, because sometimes on the tougher bases, you might not be able to get the 50% and the Town Hall. You might just get the Town Hall. So you want those Wizards to pick off things on the outside. Maybe save 3 or 4. I've saved up to 9 at a time if I'm carrying a lot of them. But really just save 3, 4, maybe 5, or an archer or 2 archers. And then pick off stuff on the outside. It may not look like you can pick off buildings, but you can see here, I'm able to pick off this building even though there's an archer tower right there. I was just out of range and I got an extra percentage. I didn't need it, but it is a good point. Now for this last one with the 3 golems and no jump, I'm trying to remember if I've forgotten anything. Like when you attack with the 3 golems, you want to go in this sort of V-shaped pattern. It's called LRC. It means left, right, center. You drop your left golem, right golem, then center golem. On the LRC, it's normally talking about Go Wee Wee, where you wait with the 3rd golem, the center golem. But in the case of this attack and most Go Wipes, you don't really need to wait because you also have the tanking ability of your P.E.K.K.A. when you deploy them. So you don't have to deploy the tank late in the center. But if you want to, you can. It will definitely protect your heroes a little bit better. And dealing with the Lava Hounds, that's one thing I should have talked about. And yes, I'll talk about it now. Dealing with Lava Hounds. Now, a Go Wipe does not have as much anti-air as a Go Wee Wee would have, because really there isn't anything except the Queen and a couple Wizards. So that's what you gotta do. When you see that Lava Hound come out, you need to drop your Queen near there, but make sure it's cleared so she'll still go in. You may have to drop her off to the side, but make sure that you clear all the buildings to the wrong side so she doesn't go on the outside, and that's exactly what happened with mine. As you can see, I raged my first rage on Wall Breakers alone to break open the core when nothing else was there with them. I did that specifically because you have to open the core. You have to get through. And I did exactly that. I was able to get through, and my hero, my King, was able to get back out with his ability. It's more important to get into the core, even if you have to use a rage, than it is to rage your stuff in the core. Even though rage really helps your P.E.K.K.A. and all that stuff, it's more important for you to get into the core than it is to rage the core. But also you wanna overlap your rage just on the edges of each other, drop a rage on the front side to get in, and then middle and back side to get out. So those are the basics of the Go Wipe with the Lightning Spell. The difference between the Lightning Spell and the non-Lightning Spell, which I'm going to be making in about 2 days maybe, what it is that you don't have that extra spell. You don't have a 5th spell that you can deploy on your own troops. Now, It may not seem like a lot, and you may say, well, you didn't use your lightning on some of these attacks. Yeah, but I was still limited to 4 spells. I was not able to use a 5th spell. I didn't have, you know, an extra rage spell or whatever. That's the main point of it. That's the main handicap to bringing a lightning spell. Now, if you do use a lightning spell, try that freeze technique, where you start from the opposite side of the clan castle, freeze it on top of a bunch of defenses, or heroes, or both, and then lightning them right there, because it's a lot easier to hit a stationary target than it is. Never try and lightning a moving target. Wait for them to stop moving or freeze them in place. Do not try to lightning a moving target. You will probably not get it unless you are very skilled and very well practiced with the lightning spell, because then if you have a train of archers, I have actually been able to take out like 90% of the archers as they move, running as single file line almost through the lightning spell. That has worked, but try and lightning them on things that you can destroy with lightning, like a hero platform, or try and freeze them with a bunch of defenses and the heroes and lightning them there, or do both. Try and do that. Get a little extra percentage, freeze some stuff with them, do something else. Get them down while helping yourself with your attack. And other than that, bringing a jump spell or bringing extra wall breakers is really up to you, what your playstyle is. But if you don't bring a jump spell, you're going to need to rage out of the core instead of jump out of the core. Or if you use your jump spell first, you're going to have to do that anyways. But still, this is the main types of army I use. Mostly the jump spell ones. I do sometimes use the other ones, but mostly it's the jump spell ones. And I'm going to be bringing you the one without lightning where you get, you know, 3 rage spells or whatever in maybe 2 days. And then we're going to be going to go wee wee and go wee wipe in the next week or two. So thank you for watching. I'll see you next time. Tyrael out.